Thanks for staying with us. Now, if you're just tuning in, we are starting from the basics on the road to becoming financially literate. Yes, so I want to learn about money. Now, please let us hear what you have to say. Remember, you can join this conversation. Tweet at us at WeShowAfrica1 with the hashtag WeShow, or send us an SMS or WhatsApp to 081-803-84663. Issy, you had some questions before
Absolutely.
We continue the conversation.
This is from Shehu. Shehu says, thank you to your guest for keeping budgeting simple. That has been my major problem. Thanks,
wow. Thank you, Shehu.
I really appreciate that. Then this is a question from Bingpe. Bingpe says, what is the best route to scale up on financial literacy?
To scale up, you cannot be afraid of the process. See, a lot of people have short-term memory. They want to multiply their income. Like, I have calls as, which investment can I double my money in 3 months? I said, not only could you not double your investment within three months with me, I'm not even interested in that kind of investment. Because it's part of scaling up is, number one, knowledge, which is obvious. We talk about this
Absolutely.
All the time. Number two, delayed gratification. You have to delay your gratification. And delaying gratification also, number three, exactly. And number three, you have to also understand that, you know, it's growing organically is key. Now, a lot of us get ourselves in situations that are not good because we want to double our money, or someone tells you about an investment that in 2 months you make 50%, or, you know, some of this obscene thing.
Exactly.
And you get into it. That is not being... You know, that's not learning about finance. That's not learning about investment. Somebody tells you to bring your money, give it to me, I'll give it to you 3 months. That's not learning about investment.
Exactly.
Because learning about investment, you have to understand process. And process takes time. You know, even the parable of the talent, it says, what, after a long time, somebody doubled, the guy with the 5 talents became 10. After a long time.
Yeah.
Because during that long time, you will make money, you will lose money. You make money, you lose money. And now let's talk about losses. Losses is one of those things that nobody wants to hear.
Yes.
You just want to make money. It's like somebody saying that, oh, I'm going to this employment all my life. I'm going to be employed for 40 years. I'll never be fired one day.
No.
Then sit at home, because that's the only way you can guarantee not being fired. You will make investments, you will make money, you will lose money. But you have learned the lesson, so you know how to do it better. And then you go back in and go. So process, you must be able to endure the process. And I'm not talking of inheritance, because we know that generational wealth in Nigeria typically does not pass the third generation. So you're talking about, inheritance. People, self-made billionaires are much more. They have long sustaining wealth because they build system and processes. So process is something that people don't want to engage in. And you have to understand, appreciate, and even love the process of creating wealth. I took $100, and today, a year later, it's $110. Fantastic. That is process. Because you've learned how to add 10% to it.
I think the problem people would have with that is that they would say, why can I wait for 1 year and it's just extra $10? Why can't I make it $1,000?
Yeah.
And that's why they fall prey to 60% return on investment in 3 months.
It can work for the short term, but in the long term, Warren Buffett has told us over and over again that you have to learn and enjoy the process.
All right, so this is a comment. The person didn't drop their name. It says, we have so many adults with money literacy issues. For me, I just started learning at 35. After working for years and burning down my money, there needs to be an education drive on this from primary school and above. But how do we even do that? If we were going to go into this formal educational sector, right? Are we doing anything right now? You know, are there countries that are doing things on financial literacy, teaching children from when they're young, right from school, as part of the curriculum?
No, but that's one of the troubles we're facing. You know, you spend money on buying an education, they teach you everything about financial literacy, which is probably the most important thing you need to know when it comes to managing your money. And schools in America have been talking about it, personal finance experts have been talking about it for years, and Nigeria is not immune. Personally, one of my goals, I would love to see a time when it is infused in the curriculum. From when they're young, from when they're 6, let them understand savings. By the time they're 8, let them understand management. By the time they're 16, let them understand investment. Because if you don't teach, they don't know. And when they know, they do better.
Okay, so let me take a cue from this person. I'm 35, right? and I don't know anything, right? Do I still have that chance to be able to start? And if I were going to start, you know, learning about financial literacy, where do I even start from?
That's the beauty of about financial literacy. You can learn from anywhere. You have financial literacy, people that's learned at 60. I have 60-year-old clients that they don't know anything about money. And I'm just teaching them about money. But most importantly, you have to open yourself to the process. You know that you already have time spent that you didn't learn this. So you have to accelerate your learning. So be serious about it. So you can learn. Like I said, begin when you want to go into the financial world, don't go from the way... If you engage the knowledge process from complicated terms, economic terms, you're going to be lost.
That's so, the problem.
So when you
that's the problem, but because jargons, like I just get tired.
Yes, you will get tired, and then you become anxious, and then you just drop the entire process. Like, no, I can't deal with this. Take a baby step at a time. Number one, understand that. You're not going to understand everything at one point, exactly. And you're going to be confused at some point. So be settled in that, but be determined that you want to do. Go ahead, all right? I like Robert Kiyosaki's books, but I ask you to read it with caution, because that book is not necessarily targeted towards the African terrain.
Yeah.
I have to say that, because when I teach my students, I let them read the book. I encourage them to read it. But then when we're in the class, we dissect, we tear things apart. Yeah, we have to localize it. Because if you take it, copy and paste, you're going to be in trouble.
Yeah.
But most importantly, in terms of when you're getting started, start from the personal finance principle I just gave to you. Don't try and start investing from day one. No. Save for 8 months. During the process of saving, get your paycheck. So if you're banking one of the banks, ABC Bank, you know, your paycheck comes in $100, put 20% aside. If it's 20, you can start with. Do it. If it's 10, you can start. Don't say because I can't do 40, you won't make an effort. No. If it's 10, you can do it. 5% for savings, 5% for investment concurrently. Put it aside. Till you can build it up to 40%. So keep putting aside. Do that while you're putting money aside. Then you begin to learn and read about investments.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Go to all the banks have an asset management arm.
Yeah.
Walk into them. Sit down with them. Say, you know what? Asset management, tell me the products that you have.
Do they even know what it is?
So good. If you don't know what an asset... So all the big banks in Nigeria.
Mm.
You know the big banks in Nigeria.
Mm.
I don't want to mention any particular bank or recommend any. But exactly. Each of them come with their asset management arm.
Mm.
Okay? So find out the address of the asset manager. Give them a call. Say, you know what? What products do you have?
Mm. Yes.
Some of them have mutual funds.
Mm.
Know the risk. Some of them, they guarantee involved. Your capital. Know the risk involved. And then begin to learn. That is the process of learning. You begin to learn that process. And take it baby steps at a time.
Yeah, you see, okay, sorry, I wanted to do a follow-up. Sorry.
Okay.
I'll come to you. So now... I'm in a huge financial debt, right? I don't have any savings.
Mm-hmm.
I want to start proper financial management and literacy, and I mean personal finance principles like the savings and all of that. But I have a backlog of BC.
Debtedness.
Do you understand? I'm indebted. So, how do I approach it? Would that savings be towards clearing off the debt first, or how do I go about it?
Okay, fantastic. First of all, in that case, write a list of your debts and arrange it in the most important orders, okay? So maybe you have a credit card debt that is costing you 20% per annum.
Mm.
Put that out as number one. Maybe you have mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
You need to continue to pay your mortgage or they repossess the house. So put that out. Friends and families and all of that.
Mm.
The friends and family can have a conversation with them. Say, look,
I
need to pay you off. The thing about debt is that make sure you pay off your debt. I advocate paying debt off. Don't ever want to owe people and run away. There's something called karma. It comes to bite you up later. So have a conversation. They say, you know what? I owe you this much money. I'm going to pay it off, but I just need time. Give me 6 months. Give me 8 months. From 8 months, this is what I can contribute on a monthly basis towards paying out the debt.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to have those conversations with all your debtors. All right, having worked out the metrics of how much you can afford to pay. So if you're earning $100 and you can afford to put 20 to 30% towards debt management, have a conversation, split it, and have a conversation with them and start making those payments.
Nailing it off.
Okay, so for the first 1 year, still have, even if it's 5% you can't save, because
you still need to save something.
Even if you have debt, because of the terrain we're in.
Mm.
you know, because God forbid if something happens, you don't have any savings.
You go and look for a loan again.
You know,
but
so you might need
to.
It is tough, but that's what I'm saying, that you must have, so, even if you don't have savings, if you have access to loans that you can use, that is guaranteed, then at least you know there's an emergency, there's a backup. Because people get to all kinds of health situations. If you have to pay for hospital bills and you're dying, you can't pay debt. So, Chike would say, so have that conversation and then begin to pay it off. So it could be the first year. It's not about investment because you can't afford to invest. Mm-hmm. It's about paying off your debt and making yourself debt-free. Mm-hmm. All right? So do that as much as you can concurrently while, you know, building your asset, while also learning, knowing that after a year, you should be debt-free. And then you can start with maybe mutual funds, stocks, properties, and so on.
Fantastic. Yeah, go ahead.
A situation whereby we have individuals who are not financially literate, okay? What is the effect, especially in Nigeria, we know that individuals currently, a lot of us are not financially literate. Mm-hmm. So what is the effect of being financially literate? Give me the pros and the cons.
Okay, the number one cons of not being financially literate is your shipwreck waiting to completely collapse. The ability not to manage your funds is a very dangerous situation you don't want to find yourself.
Exactly.
So it's a need. You need to have financial literacy. Mm. You know, you need to understand the basics of finance and be able to manage your money. Because it doesn't matter how much you earn. It matters how much you keep. And it doesn't, later on, you begin to understand it's not just what you keep, it's what you can multiply. Mm. So you just need to understand there's some things that, let's be honest, let's not give ourselves excuses. We just have to learn it.
Exactly.
It's tough, it's hard, but it's very much doable. Mm-hmm. If 50-year-old people can do it, you can do it.
Well, Moe, this thing is actually making me really, really feel sad that we don't have this in schools. Because I just imagine if I was put through that process from age 3, right? And I learned financial management all the way to my current age. Now, definitely I would do better.
Of course.
Right? So, I mean, we need to start advocating for maybe the government to put this as part of our curriculum. Because that's the only way you can truly empower someone.
Yes.
I was saying to EC that part of why we are even on this show, right? Part of why we talk about things like this is because we can't all be complaining about the problem. There's a problem. A lot of us are not financially empowered. We don't have real empowerment, you understand?
Even when we're empowered with finances, we do not know how to disburse.
We don't know how to manage that thing. So at the end of the day, you just have a lot of people walking aimlessly. They don't even have the hope for the next meal or whatever. And this basic knowledge can truly save and transform your life without even you doing so much.
Your family the nation.
And the nation. All right, so Ade, thank you, Ade, is always joining me from the UK. Good evening, ladies. Please ask your guest, is paying lump sum on your investment a good idea of wealth creation for the future? That's from Ade, EG Mortgage.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Paying a lump sum.
Yes. Is paying lump sum on your investment a good idea of wealth creation for the future? So he gave an example, mortgage.
Okay, so first of all, I'm going to answer a bit, but it depends on where you are. So if your mortgage is in UK or US, you don't have to pay it off. In fact, I don't advocate you pay lump sum because the interest rates, they're talking about 2-3%. You shouldn't even think about paying it off. Instead of paying it off, put that money to buy another property or put it in stocks. But when your mortgage is in Nigeria and you're paying 20%, 27% as more, then you want to pay it off. You absolutely want to pay it off because by the time you let the mortgage run its course, you would have paid. There was a time I did a calculation over
No,
it's not triple. Triple is what you pay abroad over 15 years, 20 years. In Nigeria, you'd have paid about 10 to 15 times, depending on the rates.
Oh, my goodness.
At 27%, come on. 20-something percent, yes.
So if you the money.
And that house is never going to be worth that entire lifetime. So it's never worth it.
In Nigeria. So if it's you have the it. Money, it is best
to
in this
off.
Climate here. Did you hear that?
I would even prefer if you want a mortgage, you have to treat it like credit card in Nigeria. So that means within months, within a year to pay it off. Otherwise, you might just do it the old way our parents did it. Buy the land, sleep, do the foundation, rest. Deck it up.
Rest.
Take a break. Roof it. Otherwise, yes, it's long drawn and it's going to take time, maybe even years. But I promise you, you're not going to be paying 15 times. It's way cheaper.
It's cheaper than just doing it. Oh my goodness, oh, we're having fun.
Are we done?
Our time is running out. Do you have one, we have one more question.
So, if you want to advise our guests or our viewers, right, what would be your, give us like two tips on how well they are supposed to manage their finances?
How well they're supposed to manage their finances? Two tips. Understand personal finance and investment. So understand how the basics of management. So let's even make sure that when you get your income, either through a business or through a salary or through any of the four incomes I discussed last week, how do you disseminate the money effectively? So understand that. And it's different from everyone. Your lifestyle is different from my lifestyle.
Exactly.
And your current lifestyle right now is different from your future lifestyle that you're. So all of those things have to be sort of tailor-made to suit you. Like there's an example of the mortgage I gave. In UK is different, in Nigeria it's different. You can't apply a one base principle. So understand that. And but the most important thing I always stress is investment. There's none of those, if you study the wealthy, the top 100 self-made billionaires or whatever, there are two things that they understood: investments. They understood business. And that's how they created their wealth. There's no magic to it. Nobody, you know, no snake give their money or swallow their money. But that's how it was done.
Are you snake? But more. So I want to learn more about personal finance, right? So are there things that you're offering, you know, are you going to be giving us discounts or maybe free classes? So we'll just start following you right now. Because I think this conversation would have to continue throughout the course of the year. Why I'm saying this is because I know the power of what personal finance can do. You can think straight.
Yes.
No governor can come and shake 5,000 in front of you for you to sell your votes if you are financially empowered.
Exactly. Yes.
So for us, this is a mission that we have started on Ways. We want to push it. We want to be able to get many people on board to understand and just start from wherever you are. Towards that journey to financial freedom. So if I were to, if I were to come to you, you know, do you offer classes? You teach people, and if I want to learn, you know, how affordable is it for me?
Okay, there are two things we do. First, one of the core of our business, we invest in foreign investments for our clients. So that's what Money Stewards does. And then we also have Money Stewards Academy that focuses on training. So I have a program I run, Mentorship with Mo. It's a 6-week course. We teach people about personal finance, entrepreneurship, investment, global investment, and so on. So we do that. But also, yes, send me a DM on Instagram, mention Ways.
Yeah.
So the week, mention Ways. And we put together trainings throughout the year. Especially according to whatever people are demanding. So we're putting together a personal finance course very soon, and the first quarter of next year. Mention this, we'll put the training together, and we'll give you favorable rates, you know. Why not? Ways is going for a movement,
and we're backing it up. Honestly, we have to, because I want as many people to be financially free. The way I'm learning it, I want to also get more people to learn, because if we truly learn, honestly speaking, I believe that we can truly change things in this country. A lot of us are not financially aware. You see a lot of, artists and all of that, they make so much money.
And they lose it in the
second. The next thing, four years, 10 years down the line, you see them, you can't correlate. Ah, this person was booming. So I just think it's just, you know, something went wrong in terms of financial management. They didn't know what to do with the money.
Another thing I'd like to add is that you look like what you see. Okay, so a lot of us were into beauty, hair, makeup, clothes, which is great. I mean, we have to look good and, you know, enjoy our lives. But at the end of the day, who are you following? Who's your financial mentor? If I look at your page, because that would tell me where your head is at. And I see you're following 10 people and they're all artists or makeup or hair people, then I know that you're not ready for personal finance. Because in there, you should be following people that will give you daily financial tips. You know, in there should be people that will give you investment knowledge, you know, and then you begin to build it. Because trust me, this is not something that you can build it. I have students that they have a master's degree in economics or finance, and they still learn from me. Because at the end of the day, academic
Knowledge.
Knowledge is different from experiential
Absolutely.
Knowledge. So you have to live and breathe this. What are you listening to? Who are your friends? Why, if all you do is weekend parties, actual Owambe parties, that's where you're going to continue to gravitate. You need to change association. You need to begin to think that, you know what, I want to start talking to people and that are, you know, understanding economic jargons. You have to be in that mindset.
Exactly. Yeah.
I think we can wrap it up. I needed to take the last minute in. Thank you so much, Mom.
Thank you.
It's been a very insightful conversation. Keep all the conversations going on our social media platforms at Weishu Africa One on IG, Twitter, Facebook, as we continue to hear what you're saying. Now, in case you missed today's quote, here it is again. Financial literacy not only involves the ability to count your money, it also tests your ability to evaluate the cost and the benefit associated with each decision you make. Very, very key. Thank you again, Mo. Thank you, Isi, for doing this with me. We'll see you live tomorrow at 8 p.m. as we bring another great conversation to your screen. Enjoy.